team. Myself, Ryan Campidelli, Natasha Yakova, and Helen Kahn are all present and accounted for. Meeting's now called to order. We are audio and video recording. At this time, do we have any public comment? Seeing none, we'll move on to item number 3. Application for short-term liquor license, the Academy of Music, Inc., DBA, Academy of Music Theater. Date and time is July 15th, 2018, 7 p.m. to 10 p.m. at the Academy of Music, 274 Main Street, tribute to Art Steel Wine and Malt. Request fee waiver. Second day, July 21st, 2018, 7 to 10. Same place, Academy, Blackmore's Night, Wine and Malt. Request fee waiver. State your name for the record, please.
Addy McDonald.
Nice to see you.
Pleasure.
Tell us about these, please.
Well, the two events, I am requesting that we remove the July 15th event from the agenda today. I would just like to apply for the July 21st event. It's a concert. Doors are at 7, show is at 7:30, so essentially we'll have about half an hour to serve, though we'll stay open for a bit later. Two serve safe people, one of them will be myself, and I will act as manager on duty. Beer and wine. And it should be an interesting group of people.
Okay. Do you guys have any questions?
No.
I have none. Would you like to make a motion?
Sure, I'll make a motion. I make a motion to approve the application for short-term liquor license for the Academy of Music on July 21st from 7 to 10 for Blackmore's Night, Wine and Malt, and as well approve the request for the fee waiver.
Second. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Thank you very much.
Thanks,
Ed. Number 4, application for farm winery liquor license. Matters Red Hen Farm LLC, DBA, Mineral Hills Winery, August 31st, 2018, September 3rd, 2018, 10 a.m. to 10 p.m., Three County Fairgrounds, 54 Fair Street. The event is the Three County Fair Wine Tasting and Bottle Sales. Type is a farm winery liquor license to sell at farmers market and agricultural events. How you doing? Can we start?
Very good. I'm Larry Goddard from Goddard's Red Hen Farm in Mineral Hills Winery. It's about our 6th year at the Tri-County Fair. And we basically do tastings there in the wine, and they're a craft barn. Okay. And we sell bottle sales there also. We encourage people to feed the bottles with us, put them in a bag, put their name on it, and on the way out they pick it up.
Excellent. Do you guys have any questions?
I don't. Nothing's changed in how you're doing things?
Nope. Same scenarios every year.
Yep.
Same spot, I believe, as last year. Last year we had Harvick with us, another winery. Mm-hmm. I think they're going to be with us again this year. So it'll be 2 wineries in the craft barn.
Are you here representing them as well?
No. Okay. No, they're on their own.
Sure, I'll make a motion to approve the application for the farm winery liquor license for Goddard's Red Hen Farm, DBA Mineral Hills Winery, for August 31st through September 3rd, 10 a.m. to 10 p.m. at the Three County Fairgrounds. The event is Three County Fair, wine tasting and bottle sales, a farm winery liquor license to sell at the farmers markets and agricultural events.
Second. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Can I pick that up?
Yeah, send you an email in the morning when it's ready.
Okay, I'll shoot down and get it.
Yeah, or did you pay already?
I did.
Can just mail it to you if that's easier.
That's fine. We have time. Either
yeah,
way.
We have plenty of time.
Okay.
We'll send you an email in the morning.
Okay, thanks.
Yeah, bye.
Bye now.
Bye-bye. So, doesn't look like anyone's here for item 5.
Yeah, they...
So I'll skip to 6, request to set violation hearing date, Notch 8, Inc., DBA, Union Station, a tunnel bar, platform bar on the deck, 125 A Pleasant Street. Manager is Jeremiah Mica. Date of violation, June 9, 2018. So, just
everybody read it?
Yeah, we've all read the reports, I assume, right?
Yep.
Okay. We're not really discussing that at this time, just setting a date for it.
Yeah, for the most, yeah.
So the police department requests any dates?
So the officer that needs to be here, he is gonna be out on military drill the whole month of August. So, and then he's gonna be on vacation in July, the week of the 22nd, so there's only one week that could work. It's July 30th through August 3rd. Other than that, we'd have to wait until September.
Yeah, I mean, I'll be pretty busy getting ready to leave on vacation for, I fly out there.
Okay.
So I just don't know what I'm doing, it's up to you guys though, I mean, I could do that, or if you wanna push it to September, it's not a problem either.
I asked the chief if it was okay to go until September, and she said yes. And then in the meantime, I had sent that letter to them, that I sent you guys, I gave you guys a copy of that letter. Yeah, the one that I sent certified mail, just reminding them that they can't serve on that patio portion.
Oh, to the deck, yeah.
And he has since asked for paperwork to apply, so that won't be a violation as long as he's stopped doing that until he applies and until it goes through.
Until it's approved, yes.
But he has applied since I sent the letter.
And this patio section is, so when you walk, if you're walking into the Union Station building, you go up the ramp or the steps, that is the patio.
The left and the right side before you go.
But before you go up there, so it's really like, so there's the deck part that's on like the wooden deck.
Yeah, there's a railing around it.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. So it's not that, it's like
in front of it.
Right. Which you can't do that.
And there are levers there.
Because his license states wood structure or something like that.
Yeah, and it needs, and I was gonna send you this, I found it. It was an ABCC advisory for extension of premises. There's all these guidelines they have to follow. Like it has to be roped off or fenced off, so nobody can reach over and nobody can walk through. It has to, we need like a floor plan with seating capacity and maximum occupancy. And then of course they need to change the license because right now they're serving on an unlicensed premise.
Right. To see the space, like to see how.
Right, no, I know it's hard to see.
It's hard to envision it. Huh?
Okay.
It's hard to see from the photos too.
Yes.
I can kind of tell, but they added quite a bit of seating.
Yes, yeah.
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 Yeah, there's just a string of lights.
Just a string of like Christmas lights.
On the back side, there's nothing. So, he did talk to me about his plan today. So, it sounds like it's
Jeremiah did?
Yeah, I ran into one of those already. So
for the date, so does he know that there's a violation against him?
I don't know that he knows. I mean, I think he knows. I know he said he was upset with his doorman because the cops went and saw him, and the doorman never said anything to him.
Yeah, okay, so I just want to make sure that if we schedule this hearing in September, that there's nothing in the meantime. I want to make sure he knows that this is happening so he can correct anything.
How could he not know what he also received?
When your office has sent something to him?
Or the cops? They don't send a police report.
No, they don't send a thing like, hey, you violated?
No, that's where we come in when I subpoena them.
Oh, well, what did you send them as a letter?
I just sent them a letter. It was like a friendly letter telling him.
So you didn't mention the violation in that. Once we set the date,
letter
for that.
Yeah, no, this was just a friendly letter reminding him that basically you were operating on an unlicensed premise and you should stop because you're going to get in trouble if you don't. We don't want to just come at them so strong, you know, just be like,
Well, he should know there's a violation against.
He wasn't, I mean, he wasn't there that night.
Right.
And he's never, I don't, as far as I know, a police report doesn't get sent to him until I send it.
Right.
With the summons.
I thought the cop was pretty thorough in his, didn't he say that he actually spoke to everybody there?
Jeremiah wasn't there. He wasn't mentioned in the report. The only time he's mentioned is when, on the list of him to be subpoenaed as the manager of record.
I see.
And his staff was talking about it. It seems so odd to me that this would.
Well, that's why he was so upset, because from what I understand, this officer, did I read the report right in stating that he was like a couple of weeks in a row?
There were several days.
He noticed, and he's like, what's going on?
Yeah.
And Jeremiah knew nothing of it, because that same little, what is he, a manager, supervisor or something? I don't know what his name is.
Which one? Eric is the head of security.
What's his,
Eric Dowd.
That, so he goes, the guy never even talked to me. Dowd never reported.
So again, that makes me wonder, does he even know that there's a violation?
Right.
So I just want to make sure that nothing happens from now until we hold the hearing.
Right.
My inclination for that reason would be to have a hearing sooner than later, just to get it done so there isn't this window of room, because it seems like the communication around what he knows or is aware of.
Let me ask you this, that next meeting, is that just a special meeting? Because we don't have one in August, right?
We don't have one in August. We have one scheduled for July 25th, but I was planning on wiping that. And just having, wiping July and then having this violation. And there's also, there's probably going to be a few other items on that.
So with this violation, and him, what did you say, he picked up a application to?
He's going to apply for the alteration of premise, but the alteration of premise wasn't on the report. That's not what they wanted to violate him for. They are violating him for not maintaining staff at all entry and exit points, allowing people into the establishment after 1 a.m.
No signs
at the entry, and then consumption of alcohol off premise when people were drinking in the parking lot.
He has to know, because remember I texted or emailed you the pictures the very next day, there were signs of it. So somebody must have told Jeremiah.
I've seen signs
so
there
the signs
before,
there. That's
so
why
I
went and looked the very next day, and I'm like, oh, he's got signs, what are we talking about?
I think there's inconsistency in the practice of adhering to what he needs to adhere to.
And I look back in our file, we have rules for extended hours for the city, and everybody who stays open until 2 has to sign these.
Yeah.
And so he violated 3 out of 10 of them. So, and I didn't find anything in his file with it signed.
Okay.
So maybe he doesn't even know. I mean, he's been in business for a long time, so I'm sure he's at least aware of that.
And the 3 that he violated was the premise, the parking lot, and no signage?
No, the premise is actually Mass General Law, Chapter 138, Section 12.
Right. But I mean, because he served in that?
Because someone was drinking on the premise. They took their alcohol into the parking lot.
No, see, in the report, I thought I read, didn't the guy reach over the lights on the table?
That's one, too.
Yeah.
So there's 2 separate.
Yeah, but they didn't request one for that. They only requested for the one of parties leaving the patio during the fight on June 8th with beverages in their hands and walking into the parking lot and bike path.
Oh, there was a fight too?
Yeah, there was a fight.
There's a lot going on.
Yeah, there's a lot.
There's a lot.
So we have 2 options. We either, I send them a letter notifying them that there is a violation and there's one coming, and then we hold it in September so then he can try and correct some of these things, or we hold one at the end of July.
End of July would probably be better for everybody.
It would be better for him, that's for sure.
Yeah,
just because the sooner.
My question is this, can you do a violation hearing and have him
apply for an alteration of premise? That's a great question.
At the same meeting?
Yeah.
I mean, I'd be like, oh,
I think that the violation takes precedence over his application to extend his premise. Like, that's
yes.
that's a business decision that he's making, and like,
well,
well, and to correct future issues.
I don't think he understood, or maybe, I don't know.
So if we don't, you know, particularly if we don't have one of those regulation sheets with the 10 points on it assigned in his file, in his best interest, he needs to be brought up to speed on anything so that if there's any gray area for him and how he's operating in that space, it'll get cleared up. So I would, prefer to do it sooner.
So do you want to also, on your notification, send him that list of the 10 and say we need this signed back in your file?
Yeah, I can do that. I don't know if I'll send it with it because I have to send it certified mail because it's a subpoena.
Yeah.
So I'm kind of scared to do that.
Yeah.
But I will get one from him, a signed copy.
Yeah.
At some point.
Okay. Just so he's up to par on everything for his file.
Right.
Okay. So, week of the 3rd, you're saying?
The week of the 30th.
Of course. Are you away?
Well, I don't know. I'm here. I have another calendar that has, you know, just my work schedule on it. So I need to get it on my phone. So I just make a date and then I will check to see if I'm available. I think Wednesday's
ready. I guess I would say, too, I'm not opposed if he. If we set this violation hearing and you actually threw that on as an agenda, I don't know how that sets, you know, police and everybody. You know, they're coming here to testify.
Right.
And they're going to want whatever they're going to want, you know, and then to see that he's actually getting his area accepted.
And there's, it's a they're two separate conversations because with the violations, adding space to his premise isn't necessarily going to help him adhere to some of the rules, some of the issues that he's having with where he was violated. Do you know what I mean? Like it's
well, if he follows the guideline, it is.
It's
right. Because right now there's a string of lights, but that guideline says it's got to be denoted like a fence where you can't get through. So I think actually, as long as he comes in with a plan and says this is what I'm doing, and he adheres to that, that's why I think that needs to go out.
But the alteration of premise that isn't part of the violation.
Right.
That's not the only thing in the police report that he said was, he said, I respectfully request clarification if the patio portion of the deck falls under the parameters of their license, which they don't, which is why I sent the letter.
I got
so the violation will not cover any of that seating on the patio.
So that could be in the same meeting then? Because one has nothing to do with the other.
It could, yeah. I mean, if he wants to do that, he is now going to be doing it the correct way. So I don't know why
we want for everybody
exactly.
In the city,
so why
adhere to the rules and do it the right way? So if he's willing to do that,
right.
I just think it's already. And I think it's good that he's already showing, you know, that he's trying to do the right thing. So.
Right. I don't know if he'll be ready by then, but that's up to him.
Right, and as part of the conversation about that application, we can talk about time frame for him to get organized to have the proper area set.
Because it's going to need like a floor plan. And,
And then for the meeting, you'll have my little set of.
Yes, that I will bring.
And all this good stuff because I'll.
Every time they come up here and ask me to bring it, I'm like, what? And there will be a court reporter or a stenographer.
Yeah.
There.
Yeah.
No.
All right, so we're going to set that date as what? The Wednesday? The 29th?
Wednesdays are good.
So the 29th then?
That's August.
I'm sorry.
Yes.
Wednesday the 1st or the?
Wednesday the 1st.
Yes.
Yes. If it's later in the day, I can do it. Or would it be our usual time?
Yeah, do you want to do 4? I know they go longer.
Go longer, so.
I'm free anytime after 1:30, so.
Free, let's say, after 2:30.
Can I ask a question regarding this now? You sent another attachment in the latest email that had showed his other violations.
Yes.
And he paid the $4,400, did that wipe out the 2 days?
Yes, that was in lieu of suspension, so he paid $4,405.
But what it wasn't clear on, so I knew it took care of those 2 days of losing the license, but the ones that were in for 2 years.
That were suspended?
Yeah, for 2 more years, I would be inclined to include that, because if you're gonna charge somebody that kind of money, I would say that that wipes out all 4 days.
I think so, because then at the bottom it says the notice of license suspension is rescinded, so I think just like all of it is just rescinded.
Because I mean, I just didn't want the simplest thing, you know, for him, and then, because I have a feeling he would pay it again, you know what I mean?
Right.
So, not that we can't set monetary lines anyway.
No, yeah, no, this one had really had nothing to do with us, yeah.
That was my only question, so August 1st.
So 3 PM or 4 PM?
That's up to you guys.
Josh is available, I would set up for 2:30.
So you wanna do 3 o'clock? Yeah.
Okay.
I think there's only been one other since I've been on.
We're gonna go back to item number 5, application for farm winery liquor license, Hardwood Vineyards and Winery LLC, date and times, August 31st, 2018, 4 PM to 10 PM, September 1st, 10 AM to 10 PM, September 2nd, 10 AM to 10 PM, September 3rd, 10 AM to 8 PM, place 3 County Fairgrounds, 54 Fair Street, before the 3 County Fair. Type of license is farm winery liquor license to sell at farmers markets and agricultural events. Can you please state your name for the record?
John Sandman.
John, thanks for coming.
You're welcome, thank you.
So we assume it's the same as you've done, I think you did that last year with Mineral Hills?
Exactly.
Same, yeah, okay.
Same.
Everything, all the paperwork's in order, I don't have any questions, do you?
I don't have any questions.
If you'd like to make a motion.
I'll make a motion to approve the application for farm winery liquor license for Hardwood Vineyards and Winery LLC on August 31st, 4 to 10, September 1st, 10 to 10, September 2nd, 10 to 10, September 3rd, 10 to 8, at the 3 County Fairgrounds, for the 3 County Fair.
I'll second that, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks for coming.
You're welcome, happy summer.
You too.
Any new business at this time?
None.
Okay, seeing none, make a motion to adjourn.